because I ain't doing this, I just close everything out. Because my life ain't like this, I just close the world out. That's not how you're supposed to do it. You know, I got people to reach, man. I got things to say. I got a story to fucking tell. You know how much shit I've been through, man? Trapped in my head, bro. Because I don't want nobody to know my shit, so I just trap myself down, man. A lot of shit been going crazy, man. Like, for real, for real. I haven't been doing what I need to do in my life, where I need to be. I haven't been putting that effort in. So my life is now really going crazy. It's all over the place. It's discombobulated. But you know what? I'm learning so much. I'm sorry, y'all. I was learning, so sorry for the noise. But I'm learning so much just in these couple of days, man. I've done so much in these few days than I have ever done in my life. And it's because, you know, if you don't make those moves, life's going to move you to make those moves. And that's what's been happening, you know. I've been crying, I've been complaining, and when I say crying, I mean complaining. I've been complaining about the things that I don't have. Oh, why I ain't driving this, or why I ain't wearing this, or why I ain't, you know, got this house or whatever. And it's because I haven't been putting the work in. I've been wanting shit so easy that I'm making my life harder because I'm waiting for that. I don't know what I'm waiting for, you know? I know I need a market. I know I need to get my clients for my business, right? But for some reason, I'm not hitting the pavement. I'm waiting for people to come to me. That's not going to happen. I don't care how much content you put on YouTube and TikTok and all of that shit. You got to do the hard work to get what you need. And that's what I'm trying to instill in my head. But you know what? I haven't been doing that. So because my ass want to lay back and wait for people to book me, hey, my lifestyle and the things that I have are going to be a reflection of that. I'm gonna keep waiting because ain't nobody coming to me and saying, hey, Jay, we love you, man. You're so amazing. We want to, you know, pay for your shit. You know what I'm saying? It's like, nah, I'm going to make y'all pay for my stuff. You know what I'm saying? So this past couple of days, I've done more in this past week. I've started budgeting. I started money management. I started just going after jobs, not ones that I typically get, or excuse me, not ones that I typically like, or that are in my niche market, but the ones that, fuck, I'm a cleaning guy. So whatever jobs fall under that line, either it's general labor, you know what I'm saying, hoarder and cleanup, whatever, like, I'm taking it, you know what I'm saying? I found myself back on Craigslist, but with a different mindset, you know, trying to find gigs and trying to find jobs so that I'm not waiting around, you know what I'm saying? Like, there's one thing to wait around, but if you're waiting around your bills stacking up, that's not a good look. And, you know, that's what honestly was happening. Like, I was waiting around. I was doing, because I have clients, you know, I've gotten clients since February. You guys know I've been marketing and stuff like that on Craigslist, put out that special. And, you know, I got a few clients. And after those clients, when I did the deep cleaning, they've been ongoing. So I got my regular monthlies, regular weeklies, and regular bi-weeklies. The thing is, I haven't got any new clients. So my monthly money is looking the same, you know, each month. And it's not elevating because I'm not marketing for the clients that I need, and I'm not doing any of the legwork that I need. It's just sad. You know, it's really sad and disappointing to see that I'm willing to sit here and wait almost for a handout, to someone to come to me and to want my business. Like, but I know I'm not actively putting out content. I know I'm not actively putting out flyers. I'm not going door to door asking people, hey, you know, I'm a cleaning guy, you know what I'm saying? I do amazing work. You know, here's a little deal, here's an offer, I do one room or whatever. I'm not doing any of that. So I look around and I got 5 clients for the whole month. I'm not making no money. You know what I'm saying? I'm not making enough to live. I'm not making enough to spend. I'm not even making enough to have a lifestyle of any type of sort. And so shit is looking real bummy right now. You know, and I'm just out here really hitting the pavement and really grinding. Y'all know I did that post-construction cleanup. I worked for 13 hours, yo. And I ain't make... But I had to do something instead of waiting around. You know what I'm saying? If I'm not going to actively market, if I'm not going to actively work on my business intentionally, then I need to be getting some other income somewhere. If I'm not going to work at fucking Applebee's or Chili or fucking Chick-fil-A, I need to get my ass up and start finding odd jobs tax-free and making money that way. Like, this shit is a life crisis right now. It's a state of emergency. My life is serious, a state of emergency. Like, I never thought I would ever be here. That's the crazy thing. I received all the tools to get me to where I could go. You know, as a young kid, my mom had me in all sorts of things: gymnastics, tennis, swimming, karate, taekwondo, ballet. But I was like, fuck this. Fuck that. I don't want that shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, fuck. I don't want that. Like, just curving all of that shit. As I got older, you know, I stayed with tennis. That's the thing. I did stay with tennis. I was in the Harlem Junior Tennis Program. Anybody know? Shout out to Dante. But I failed on that because I was just like, fuck this. My mom got sick. And I was just like, I don't need tennis. Like, fuck tennis. Like, you know what I'm saying? So I was just like, fuck this. And I dropped out of tennis. And then I just dropped out of high school. Then I just stopped doing fucking anything. You know, I went to school. I went to college. When I met my wife, we went back to school together just so I could finish. You know what I'm saying? Because I dropped out. So I went back. I was actually going to TCI. Went to TCI. It was a technical vocational school. And I got my GED and my associate's degree at the same time. That's around the same time I met my wife. You know, she was really encouraging. I was like, damn, you know what? Right, I got to finish because I don't got no credentials. Went back to school, finished, boom, got my associate's. Then leveled up, got my BA. The thing is, I ain't do nothing with those degrees. So, you know, those degrees just been sitting duck. And I looked at myself the other day. I said, bro, you have no skill. You have no carpentry skill. You have no plumbing skill. You have no skill at all. The only skill you got is cleaning. So you got to understand, like, it's either that you go back to school and get a fucking degree and get some training, do some YouTube shit, or, bro, let your cleaning shit talk. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got to pick one or the other. You can't just be out here not doing anything. And, you know, it's my third year. It's about to be my third year here down in North Carolina, bro. And it's one thing to kind of, you know, leave the city, come down south, you know, and, like, struggle, okay, for the first year. Because we was good, like, you know what I'm saying? Unemployment, you know what I mean? We had that cash and all of that shit. And then shit just started because I never changed. So I moved. But I never changed the concept of what I wanted to do. Like, I tried. I swear I tried, you know? And that's when I was like, all right, I'm going to go to FedEx. Went to FedEx. And when I got COVID, I left FedEx. And I took that as a sign and really started focusing on my business. But then I focused on my business only a little bit to get in the door. And in February to now, I got like a handful of clients. I got two weeklies reoccurring. One on Monday, one on Friday. But the one on Friday about to drop because I think, whatever, money issues. So they about to drop me, but they about to do like once a month. I got a bi-weekly. And everything else is kind of like book as you go. You know what I'm saying? Like when people feel. Not when people feel, but like when it gets time to book, like whatever. So monthly, you want to say. But that's it. You know, that counts my income for everything. And it's been real tight. You know, I need at least 5K a month. And I need to grind out about 10K a month. You understand what I'm saying? Because I need to start saving. I need to start building up these accounts. Like, I want to have shit, bro. Like, I want to have travel funds and fucking savings accounts and shit and just all of this shit. I just want to have what I never had. I've been in this struggle survival mode for entirety of my life. You know what I'm saying? I grew up, my mother gave me, you know, black parents. They gonna give you what they feel like you need. That's it. You ain't gonna get any more and you ain't gonna get any less. You just gonna get exactly what you need to get. So that was my lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? And I wanted more. So mom would, you know, fix me something to eat. I want that. You know what I'm saying? I want some junk food. I want some goddamn Chinese food. So I would find a hustle to so I can get what I needed. Like, food was a big thing for me, man. Snack. I needed what I needed. So I started hustling early, man. I started selling phones. I was on Craigslist from a kid, man. Like 2003, I've been on Craigslist, bro. Like, I've been always in this survival mentality. And I haven't gotten out of it. And it's part of my trauma. It's part of my trauma, always feeling like, you know, I just got to get it up until a certain point and I just drop it because I don't need it anymore. And so that's exactly what it's been. I never kept the ball rolling enough to be like, okay, I have a breather, and then I'm going to keep going after that. I just be like, oh, I got a breather, and I'm not ever doing it again. You know what I'm saying? Because I have fulfilled the mission. You know what I mean? I got the money for the food. That's all I need. I don't need any more money, so I don't need to do any more work. But that's evident in my lifestyle today. You know, I don't have a lifestyle. I like to say it's the bummy lifestyle, you know? You living the paycheck to paycheck. And the fucked up thing is, I'm going to be an entrepreneur. I'm not living goddamn paycheck to paycheck. Like, fuck all that. I'd rather go to goddamn Chili's and live paycheck to paycheck. Fuck, I'm being an entrepreneur, make my own money, my own sacrifice, my own goddamn marketing. Like, bro, I'm supposed to be leveling up to a way, like, you know, ever before. So, man, I had to do some crazy things this week, man. And when I mean crazy things, I mean just out of my element. 13 hours? I've never worked 13 hours straight. And first of all, that's fucking illegal. But I had to do what I had to do. I was scraping paint or fucking tile floors for 13 fucking hours. Cleaning baseboards, washing down walls, cleaning bathrooms, post-construction, doing a three-bedroom, two-bathroom house, doing a garage out back. Bro, I was fucking slaving for my goddamn life because I needed the money, yo. Like, that's how bad it was. And today's job? Bro, today's job was a semi-hoard. Let me show y'all. Check the clips, man. Check this shit out. But what's crazy, you know, this job had me so full, man. You know, it's weird, right? So the people that I clean for, man, it's not that they don't need it. It's that they can do the shit themselves. But clearly, you guys already see what the situation is, what kind of situation is going on. You know what I'm saying? And those are the people who need it, man. Those are the people who need it the most. So, it's just like, wow, you know, this is really showing me, like, that grit. You know, and it's also directing me in different paths. I'm meeting new people, man. I'm just becoming out of my element. Like, this is what I wanted from FedEx. But I guess FedEx wasn't enough for me. It's this grind, man. It's this hustle. I miss this shit. But you know what? I just got to be more intentional with it. I just got to take what I did back in the day and level up now. That's all, man. The game ain't changed, bro. It's just me. It's just my goal at the end of the day. So, you know, I've been stressed, but it's a good stress. I've been having to stretch myself. I've been having to, you know, kind of tell myself, yo, I was bitching a fit. I learned a lot about myself, man. You scraping floors for 13 fucking hours by hand? Oh, you gonna learn a lot about yourself. Ain't no way. You know what I mean? Like, I was bitching a fit. I was just pissed. I was complaining in my head. I was just like, yo, what the fuck? Like, don't they know I'm a residential cleaning guy? Like, what the fuck that matter? I had to do what the fuck I had to do. You know, so it's just like these past couple days, I've just been forced to just zone in and lock in, man, because I've had no other choice. I got bill people calling me, bro. I got fucking rent to pay, and I'm trying to catch up with this bill and catch up with that bill. I got a vet appointment. My cat got a vet appointment that, yo, it was easy peasy paying them bills in the early months, bro. Early years when we got down here. Now I'm like budgeting. Yo, we was in Sam's Club the other day, right? And I'm like, oh, shit, I can only pay, I got to take the napkins back. Like, usually I'm able to put like $200 to paper stuff. Now I got to put like $60, $70. I got to be like, I'll put the napkins back. I can only get Bounty and fucking fucking laundry detergent, whatever. You get what I'm saying? I can only get a few at a time. This shit is crazy. This shit is wild, bro. But you know what? I've been in an illusion. I've been in an illusion. You know, my mind's been altered, like, everything's okay just because I have enough. You know what I'm saying? I got enough of Sam's Club, or I got this income coming in from this, you know, say, unemployment. It's all right. I'm good. I don't need to do no work. I'm straight until the shit run out. Then what? What you left with? You think that shit going to double back and give you an extra $14K? Hell motherfucking no. You know? So I can't live like this, you know? I can't continue to live like this. I haven't done a lot in my life, but I'll be damned if I continue to have nothing, man. Like, that shit is just, no. I'm tired of where I am, man. I'm tired of going in the past, thinking what shit I should have done and should have did. Man, please. I'm just tired of it, man. And the thing about learning the lessons, thing about life is you got to get tired with you. Like, everybody can give you advice. You can see movies and wish for things you don't want to be happening, or wish for things you don't want to be true. But you got to feel that shit deep down in your gut and not want it anymore, bro. It's like you got to look at yourself in the mirror and be so scared of who you are becoming and so disgusted. And I'm on day 13 of NoFap. I ain't had no time to do that shit. Fuck that shit. I've been struggling and surviving for my life these past couple days, bro. But it feels rewarding, you know? As much stress, like I said, that I've been going through these past couple days, I've done more fucking traveling and driving in these 3 fucking days or 3 fucking weeks than I ever have in my fucking time being down here. If that don't tell you something, then I don't know what you want from me. Because this is King's journey. This is my fucking life. You know, this is just raw in the cut, man. Like, there's no glamour to this lifestyle right here. But if y'all listening, if you are out here, I know y'all out here, man. Like, I know that it's going to take the depths of you to become this person, bro. But it's going to be so rewarding. Like, you got to fight for yourself. Don't do it for your wife. Don't do it for your kids. Don't do it for your man. Don't do it for your husband. Don't do it for your damn dog, bro. Do it for you. Do it for you, man. I'm telling you, just put fear aside, bro. Put it aside. Like, I can't go back no more. This is it. I cannot go back to the mundane lifestyle. I cannot go back to not having. I cannot go back to not traveling, bro. I haven't been anywhere since fucking 2000 and goddamn 7. I went to France on a fucking, what do they call them shit, student exchange. I haven't been out the country since, bro. I haven't been out the country before that, and I haven't been out the country after that. That's fucking sad. I'm 33 fucking years old, about to be 34 in February, and the only place I've been to is France that I damn near don't remember? Hell fucking no. If that don't make you and motivate your ass, get your ass up. Get your motherfucking ass up right now, bro. For real, for real. Because it's time, man. People was moving and shaking out here like none other. People was traveling, doing fucking year tours and shit. Going from here to there. Don't you want to go? Shit, I be looking like, damn. I be seeing motherfuckers hopping. 3 different cars that are up. Freedom. Opportunity. Lifestyle. Bro, come on. Let's get this work, bro. Let's get this working. If I got to show y'all my ugly side and my ugly truth, then so be it, man. But we gonna do this journey together, yo. Man, the game has changed. It's all social media. That should be making me depressed. I don't know about y'all, but that should be making me so depressed. Like, I be looking at people's lifestyles and shit and the stuff that they have and the stuff that they doing. And I don't want to be envious, but I be like, oh, my God. What the fuck? Like, why ain't doing my shit? Like, yo, what? You got that, and I don't. Like, what makes you any better than me? You know what I'm saying? When you start asking yourself that, that's when that shit kick in. Because you ain't no better than me, and I'm no better than you. And what the fuck you got 3 fucking goddamn Teslas in your damn garage for, and I don't have one? Like Tupac said, it don't make sense how a motherfucker can be so rich and somebody can be so poor. I swear to God, I feel that shit every fucking day, man. Every fucking day. Every fucking day I get in this vehicle, I be like, yo, I gotta change my life. I gotta change my life. So, yeah, you know, we don't see the work that's being done in the background. You know what I mean? Man, I'm tired. When I got off that 13-hour job, I went from Charlotte home. I still had an hour ride at 2 a.m. Bro, I had to 3 o'clock, 3:30, I got home. Didn't wake up until got 2 hours of fucking sleep because I had to be back up at like 6, 6:30. So, man, let's get this money. Let's get this work. Let's get this body right. Let's get this traveling passport stamp. Let's get this shit going, baby. Day 13. September is coming. It's a new time, baby. You know, we done said it. We done talked about it. We done tried to do it. We got to walk that walk, man. We got to talk and walk. We got to walk it like I talk it. We got to do this shit, man. I'm about to go in, upload these photos, make this real, because this work that I put in today, yo.
This is a work of
damn, that thing's a work of art.
Instead of waiting for a good day to happen, you know, waiting around. Ups and downs, you know, I just said, look.
You see why they call me the king, baby. This job really made me so full. It has me second guessing my whole niche, because it's funny, I've been doing a lot of work, but I haven't been rewarded for it. You know, a lot of people is bitching over stupid shit. Man, you could clean that shit yourself. People out here that need super, super help. You know, so I'm willing to get that type of gratification and satisfaction and help those who really need it. Not this stupid shit that I've been doing. Oh, let me sweep and make your bed and shit. Nigga, you could do that shit your damn self. I'm talking about people who are sick here that they can't even, you know, operate and go outside. So the walls are closing in and their life has shit. I'm going through the same shit. And I told the man, I said, you know what? This job did a lot for me. I wonder how many people told him that today. Well, any day, whenever they serviced him. But I said, hit me up, call me, man. You know, so I don't got to get that bad, so we can help you out, man. These past couple of days been super great, man. They really been great. I need this, man. I need this shit, bro. I need this adventure. I need this struggle. I need this. I just need it. I need to go with the challenges of life and fight against the grain and keep going and propel myself, because the easy way, that's for suckers. Peace and love, y'all. It's the boy King J. I appreciate y'all. I appreciate y'all for staying subscribed. A lot of y'all still subscribed. I haven't even been dropping content. Thank you. Now, I know a lot of comments have been coming. I know that FedEx video dropped. But man, stay tuned to the channel. I got other videos, man. But I'm willing to answer more comments. I haven't been on YouTube. I see y'all comments coming in, and but that's me. That's what I'm struggling with. Because I ain't doing this, I just close everything out. Because my life ain't like this, I just close the world out. That's not how you're supposed to do it. You know, I got people to reach, man. I got things to say. I got a story to fucking tell. You know how much shit I've been through, man? Trapped in my head, bro. Because I don't want nobody to know my shit, so I just trap myself down, man. You know, so I hope I help somebody today. You know, that's part of this journey right here, is to help somebody. Help somebody other than your fucking self. Or you helping yourself, help somebody else along the way. Pick them up, man. Shit, it's 2020 fucking two. The world is going crazy. You know what I'm saying? The world is going crazy. It's just, you gotta help people. People need help. You need help. And let's not run away from the fact. Can't think you perfect. Or ain't nothing wrong with you. I don't care what the fuck's going on. You know how you feel inside. You gotta become one with that shit, bro. And work on yourself. I can't afford therapy right now. I don't know about you, but I can't afford it. But I'm gonna do what I gotta do to get up out this slumber. Get up out this mindset. Stop letting this shit carry me and hold me, bro. We all been through trauma and struggles and strife and pain. People done did shit to us, and, you know, we done did shit to people because we done put our fucking pain on others. Today is a new day. Today is a new day. Peace and love. It's the King, baby. Appreciate y'all for subscribing. If you have not subscribed already, y'all should hit that subscribe button, man. Tell a friend to hit it, too. You know what? Tell a friend to hit it too. Tell your girlfriend, your boyfriend, your best friend. Tell them to hit the subscribe button, man. Share this video, matter of fact. And that subscribe, that notification bell, hit that bitch too. So you always stay... you always stay current, yo. That's the fun thing about it. Especially because I'm not editing, so... I felt like I was going to say something, but it just didn't come out. I was supposed to say, always stay current, always stay live. You always stay notified when I drop content. Never miss a video, okay? Never miss a video. All right, y'all, let me go home. I got to take a shower, and then I'll put this content up, and then I'm getting something to eat. Peace.